YouTube, how you doing? I have Twitch watching. I am live. How are you doing, little girl? I hope you're doing well. We are playing Mono Green Standard. We are currently Platinum 3. We're having trouble getting out of Platinum 3 right now. We're just, we're not doing so hot over here in Standard Land. Yikes. Gonna go more than that. I hate to say it, but I can't actually, like, go down another. I don't think we win this deck. I don't think we're gonna win this game, but we're gonna keep it there. Alright, we have one chance to draw land or we're screwed. Ah, Tenacious Thunder, that's so good. Oh, we got so lucky there. So, a 2-2. We're probably gonna take 3 because I don't think I blocked that. I just don't believe it. Never mind, we're gonna lose. At least he didn't have a turn one play like the ball gets later, but yeah, we're behind the bet. We're behind the ball here. Put Titania down. Into Sheldred. Destroys me. Fuck. We gotta get rid of Tyvar's stance at this time. He did have the Evolver Sleeper, by the way. Quirion Beastcaller. Nice. We're going to discard Tyvar's stand, most likely. Resolve. Hard to beat this, but manageable. Let's get out of here. Now we lose. This hand was way too good. Look at that. Evolve Sleeper, two shoulders in it. There's a Thunderdog, Liliana into a Phyrexian Obliterator. And he had a second Phyrexian Obliterator, amazingly enough. You know, I just like to see him play the Shieldred. I should give the happy face? He thinks, no, we're giving the sad face. Why the fuck? Who had a good time there? Who had a good time there? I'm sure our opponent had the greatest time in the world, given the greatest hand I've ever seen in my fucking life. He didn't draw the Evolved Sleeper in opening hand, thank fucking God. But yeah, still, Tenacious Underdog, Liliana, into Shieldred's Edict, into Phyrexian Obliterator, had a second Phyrexian Obliterator, and had an Evolved Sleeper, and got the third Shieldred Edict. You cannot... Why would I click the smiley face in that regard? Oh my god. Why did it give me 5 of these? Let me go first. Don't even care. Don't even care, man. After watching that last game and get totally fucking butt-fucked by this RNG generator, I'm like, Jesus, give me whatever hand. Let's play this game. They mulligan twice. Look at this hand. We got 4 or 5 drops. And it's an enchantment deck. Making good plays, but I think he doesn't understand what I'm about to do. Do you have another one? No, we were harmed. I'm taking three. No block. Alright, let's see if it's done. Oh, that is just the best. Vorinclex? In the Kodama? And put it into play. There you go. The game's over. Even if he copied that. Seven, Nissa. Nissa is such a, like, she's the game winner. You know what I'm mad about? I had four of her, and I sold them. I sold them for, like, nothing, too. I sold them for, like, $5 a piece. Huh. It's really interesting. Because you could use that to your advantage. These games have been fast. We've already been to two games, YouTube, and we're moving right along. We might even get, like, a third or fourth game in here. We got the finisher, the game winner, so we just go bang, 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 bang. Oh, we have nothing to do with two Gwennas. That's actually not that good. I wonder if long term I maybe start to use some type of elf strategy with this instead. Like, because right now I'm using it as a tempo deck, but if I'm going to keep using Gwenna and big creatures, I wonder if I use more elves as well. Just my thoughts on that right now. Probably gonna blast this. I would, yeah. I got nothing to do next turn, so. Yeah, we actually didn't have a pretty good follow up there. I'm going to put the Bloated Contaminator down. See if he has any more removal before I put Gwenna down. I figure 4 health is a lot of health. He could deal with it. I know they can deal with it. I prefer to have 4 health. To force him to deal with the 4 health, because 2 health or 3 health, too easy, lightning strikeable. But 4, not lightning strikeable. Or play the creature in your hand. Like, he has a choice. Play the creature, then he gets a +1/+1, or hit me with spells. I think you hit me with spells. Like, the here is warp smithing or whatever, do 5 damage to target creature. Or just put it in a big creature. Do a lot of damage, that's for sure. Alright, Quirion Beastcaller. I mean, we could have gave him a 2-2, but it would have happened. That 2-2 is going to do some damage. Now he's going to blast it. Yeah, I knew it! See, here he's Warcrafting. Knew they had it the whole time. Play the land. No blocks. 4 mana. Next. Enter. We can destroy either one. Yeah, keep pushing the damage. Next. And turn. Risk, but we gotta take it. Set up lethal next turn. Set up lethal next turn. Alright, he wins quite a few cards here. Very easy for him to win. Just to convoke 4 damage. There we go. And that's lethal. Nissa was a huge risk that game. Nissa was a huge risk, taking 4 life damage like that. Huge risk. We could, I mean, he has enough damage, or he gets the convo 4 damage. We were just blown out of that game. I mean, but that's just how games like that go. I mean, you could turn around like that. I was getting mad playing Is It Prowess earlier, because sometimes if you just fall behind, it feels like there's no way to get back into the game sometimes in Standard. Like, if we were in the Pioneer, like, oh my god, there's massive ways to get to the game. But Standard, if you fall behind, it really feels like you're doomed. Look at this. We're keeping it fair, buddy. Because we're crazy. Here we come. And we did not get anything. All attack. We missed our land drop, because we suck. Land of our last speaker. We missed another land drop. It's 2. It's 3. We've drawn now 9. So to get to 10, are we going to get to 10 cards before we draw land? There it is. So we're going to draw a full 10 cards without getting a land. We drew 10 cards and only drew 2 lands. Just want to say that. I don't want to talk about, like, the improbability of that. It's just, you saw it. I'm mad about it, but there's just nothing to say. You all saw it. It's on recording. We should have kept it, but just think about that. We drew 10 cards and it had 1 land. The unlikeliness of that is so high, it's ridiculous. It's Cankerbloom. I probably should have taken the treasure. But I actually just want to destroy that. So now they're both in there. No attacks. So he's got both in there, so we're gonna have an honest game here. I should have created a tap treasure token, to be perfectly honest, right there. Okay. That card's really good. Kodama's fine. Gala Greeter in the Gala Greeter. Oh, yeah. In the Quirion Beastcaller. Plus one. Bang. So when we drop the next creature next turn, we're gonna hit him for 4. Damn. Straight up Kura. Actually, no, it's Gwenna. Sorry, that's the better play. If we can get it off. Alright. Kura, the Boundless Sky. End turn. I have a feeling he's going to remove it, so we're not playing the other creature. With 1 depopulate, I suspect he's going to remove it again, so I'm trying not to get ahead of myself here. I don't want to put that down yet. I think he's going to clear this, and then we start rebuilding again. I mean, shoot, he just drew 4 cards, everybody. So, I mean, he can do anything he wants. Next turn. End turn. Shit, what did we lose, right? We lose the game. It's... Man, that sucks. much, man. She has blockers, right? Sent that a chase. There we go. Yikes. We totally scammed that dude. That dude got scammed. Like, the game gave me the victory right there. He board clears and gets scammed by the Zelfiel. Oh my lord. Thank you for watching, everybody. Appreciate you stopping by. Please give me a like, subscribe, and I will see you all next time.